All right, so now that you know how to snap and zip your way across the timeline, let's delete everything here and start making our rough cut the right way. So what we wanna do here is we wanna look at our footage, decide which shots are crap, which shots are great, trim the fat off the good stuff, and then line it up in a sequence that we can fine tune in the next lesson. So it's like we want to lay out and prep all our ingredients before we start cooking, right? So I'm gonna show you lots of ways to do this. We're gonna start out slow and then we're gonna get faster and faster, okay? All right, so let's start by picking out some good shots from our footage here. And we're gonna start by just hovering our mouse from left to right over our clips. And I want you to notice what happens. It's playing a preview of our footage, right? All right, so let's hover over these first two shots here. And I can see that these were the shots where that camera was face up on the ground and we were laying the blanket over the lens, right? And I remember this is a shot that we did twice and the second take was better. And a lot of times that's the case, that I'll look at the last take because that's the one where we perfected things, right? So here, I know we want the second clip, but we don't want all of it, right? We don't want the beginning of it where we're just staring at the sky. And I don't want the end of it where my face comes in here and I'm turning the camera off. I want to trim out only the good parts and just add that to my timeline. Now, if I click to select this clip, then I hover my mouse left to right, then you'll notice that I can't hover anymore. Hovering down here on a clip that's not selected, well, that lets me be way lazier. And so that is my preferred method of previewing. And so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna go up to this edit menu and I am going to pick deselect all because I don't want this clip selected, I wanna hover. All right, now I am gonna hover over in this clip to the part where we want it to start. So where we want this clip to come in, and that is called the endpoint. So I'm gonna press the I key, and that is going to set my endpoint on this clip. And you'll notice that this little blue line down here has gotten shorter, and everything before our endpoint is grayed out and has been trimmed off the clip. Now I'm gonna hover over to the point in the shot where I want it to go out, right about there, and that is our out point. And what key are we gonna press to set our out point? You're gonna press O. And after we do that, then you'll notice our blue line has gotten even shorter. Everything after that out point has gotten trimmed off. And if we drag our clip to the timeline, zoom in a little bit here, and we play that back, then you'll notice that only the highlighted part has been added to our timeline, which is super efficient. I mean, that just looks so cute. Now, what if we decided we trimmed too much? Well, that's okay. If we select this clip on our timeline and we drag it out, then you'll see that everything is still there, nothing's been destroyed, and so it's all good. But in this case, we had it trimmed up right, so let's undo that. And now let's get another clip on this timeline. So we're gonna go back over to our panel with the footage in it, so make sure you click on that and you don't have the timeline selected anymore. And let's hover over these next couple shots, and I can see that these are the shots, that straightforward shot of Miles and I putting the blanket down. And again, this was a shot that we did twice, and I know that that second take was one that we perfected. So I want this shot right here. Now, I'm not gonna click to select it, because if I do that, I can't be lazy and hover and preview it. But I also don't want our last clip up here selected. That makes me nervous because we ain't working on that clip, we're working on this one. And so again, I'm gonna go up to our edit menu here and I'm going to pick deselect all. Cool, now I'm gonna hover over this clip to the point where I want it to come in. So let's go to our endpoint, maybe right about here. I'm gonna press the I key to set that, go to my out point, press the O key to set that, and then drag it to my timeline. Now I'm gonna click back on the panel with our footage in it, and first thing I wanna do is I wanna deselect that last clip. So I'm gonna go up to the edit menu and go to deselect all. Now, if I'm going back and forth between my timeline panel and my footage bin here, then that's a lot of going up into this menu and going to deselect all, which is gonna take a while. So of course I use a keyboard shortcut. And you know, I have set a custom keyboard shortcut for deselect all that is conveniently located right beside the I and O keys that I'm using a lot when I'm doing this process. And I've set it to L for deselect all. You could also think of it as L for let go of that last clip. I know it's stupid. Look, I'm just trying to help you remember, okay? All right, so let's use that new keyboard shortcut. Let's press L to deselect all or to let go of that last clip. And now let's go on to our next shots and let's get a little faster. So our next shots are with the camera inside of that picnic basket where we're opening it up. And I can see from these first two shots here, I didn't have my jacket on, which was a continuity error. So I know I wanna use this third shot. So without clicking it, I'm just gonna hover, press the I key to set my endpoint, press the O key to set my out point. And now instead of dragging this clip all the way over to the timeline, let's undo that. And I'm gonna do the exact same thing real fast by just pressing the comma key. The comma key is going to insert any clip that you've got selected over here on your timeline wherever the playhead is. That means that if this blue line is in the middle of a clip on your timeline, and then I press the comma key, Premiere is gonna insert your new clip smack dab in the middle of that existing clip on your timeline and split it in two. So let's undo that. And anyway, to remember that the comma key is what inserts something onto your timeline, you can think that if you were going to insert something into a sentence, you might set it off in commas. Speaking of inserting, another way you can insert clips onto the timeline is to click on a clip, and then while you're dragging it, press the command key, and then you see those little triangles that are pointing to the right? That means that wherever you release the clip, it's going to be inserted there on your timeline. All right, so at this point, we've gone over a lot of shortcuts, so if your head is about to explode, then that's all right, I feel you. We're gonna take a minute here and we're gonna review this keystroke choreography and show you just how fast you can cut and trim clips for your rough cut using these shortcuts. And I'm also gonna drop a sick beat behind it while we review so that hopefully you can remember these a little better. Yo, y'all ain't never seen something like this.
Nah, sis.
We about to drop some bars about keyboard shortcuts.
Oh no, she didn't.
Look, here we go. Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint. Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go.
Oh.
Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint.
Oh.
Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go. I gotta make, I need to create. I need a plate for all of this cake. Got an idea, I need to film it. I just hope I don't mess up the frame rate. Actually, if you need help with frame rates, I have a video on that, link is down below. That's called cross promotion. That's how I teach you slow motion. And I put story on top, yeah, story on top. Ain't about gear, it's about that emotion. Working keys like I'm Alicia. Band-aids on my fingers, butter on my B-roll. Testing beta features, you look dope in my t-shirt.
Merch, look.
Preview in my edit, dang, it's so fly. Let a hater try me.
Lock.
I be like, goodbye. I was born to edit, scissors on my neck. I like trimming clips, I like chips and dip, but nothing in this world that I like more than this.
Shortcuts.
All I really wanna use is
shortcuts.
I don't really need a mouse either.
Shortcuts.
All an editor need is
shortcuts.
Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint. Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go.
Oh.
Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint.
Oh.
Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go. Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L, let go. Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L. Bruh, I will hover like Casey. Sis, I stay peachy like DG. Drink coffee like Peter McKinnon. Ain't worried about haters' opinions. Ergo all day with my Jarvis. Fill bins like I'm shopping at Target. Just notice another mistake. Third time I'm exporting today. Script like I'm Darius. Filming like I'm Harris. Gimbal like I'm Kitty. Share it like I'm Shameless. Edit like I'm OD Show. Bootstrap like any mogul, bro. Marky and Marky out, there you go. Watch it back, trim it up, make it flow. Can even edit with my big toe. I am scared of beach balls though. I was born to edit. Scissors on my neck. I like trimming clips. Smoke coming off my tip. But nothing in this world that I like more than this.
Shortcuts.
All I really wanna use is
shortcuts.
I don't really need a mouse either.
Shortcuts.
All an editor need is
shortcuts.
Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint. Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go.
Oh.
Hover to preview. I to set the endpoint, O to set the outpoint.
Oh.
Click to select. Comma to insert, L to let go.
Oh.
Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L, let go. Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L. Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L, let go. Hover, I, O.
Oh.
Click, comma, L, let go.
Shortcuts. 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 Shortcuts.
All right, let's get back to business. Let's get back to our edit. So we've been talking a lot about pressing the comma key to insert on the timeline, right? But how does Premiere know which track on the timeline to insert your clip on? Well, right now our timeline's really simple and we've only got clips on video track one and audio track one. And so Premiere's just been inserting the source footage that we trim up onto those tracks. But when you start having timelines with several tracks of clips, then things get a little more complicated and you're gonna wanna tell Premiere which track you're working on. And to do that, you're gonna go to the far left of the tracks in your timeline where you see this blue V1 to the left of this little lock. And if you hover over it, you're gonna see a label pop up that says source patching for inserts and overwrites. Now that is a whole lot of words, so let's break them down. Source means your source footage over here. And patch means to connect in TV studio language. And so source patching for inserts means that whichever track you click and select here, and you're gonna know that it's selected because it's gonna turn blue, then that is where your source footage is going to get patched to, or where it's gonna be connected or inserted when you press the comma key in Premiere. And so if I select track 2 for source patching, then Premiere is gonna insert our source clips on track 2 when we press the comma key. This is also true for overwrites, and that is when you write over clips on the timeline instead of inserting them. And you can overwrite footage on a track by pressing the period key or by just dragging a clip on top of another clip on the timeline. But let's get back to source patching. If the source footage that you have selected has both audio and video, you're going to see both an A1 and a V1 that you can click and you can move around to different tracks to tell Premiere where to send your source footage when we press the comma key. Now, if the source footage you've got selected doesn't have any audio at all, then you're not gonna see an A1 down there. If the source footage you've selected has stereo sound, then you're gonna see not only an A1, but an A2. Now, when you see these little A1s and V1s, not only can you move these to different tracks, but you can also turn them off. So if you have a source clip here that has both video and audio, but let's say you only want to add the video to your timeline because the audio sucks, you can click on this A1 so that it's no longer highlighted in blue. And now when you press the comma key, there's not gonna be any audio that gets added to your timeline, it's just video. Now, source patching is not something that you need to worry about. It's not something that I'm constantly thinking about when I'm in Premiere, but it is definitely useful to know as your edits get more complicated. All right, let's get back to our edit. Now I'm gonna go over to this last clip and I'm gonna hover over it to remind myself what it was, and I can see that it was that clip with the camera inside the picnic basket while we were opening the basket and unloading it, right? So if I hover over our next clips, I can see that they are basically the same exact action, but they're just from a different angle. So they're with the camera shooting from overhead, right? So obviously I can't include both the last shot with the camera inside the basket and the shot from overhead in full of the same exact action, or it's gonna look like we did the same thing twice, right? But at this point when I'm making my rough cut, like I'm not trying to decide which one of these shots I'm using or which parts of which of these shots I'm using. I'm just trying to get anything that's potentially usable on my timeline. All right, so in this first shot, I don't have my jacket on. That's a continuity error, so we're not including that clip. In the second shot, you can barely see it, but I do have my jacket on, so that's good, because I really like the way this shot starts, the way we sit down on the blanket. And so now I'm just gonna press O for out point. I'm not even gonna press I for end point, because I like where the clip starts as it is. And now I can just click that clip to select it and press the comma key to get it on the timeline. All right, now I'm gonna press L to let go of that last clip and deselect all. And now I'm gonna hover and see if there are any other parts of this clip that we want. Like, are we ever gonna open the basket? Nope, all right. So there's nothing else in this clip that I want, but let's just pretend that I did want something here at the end of the clip. I could set a new endpoint and cut off everything else before that. And then I could click to select it, press the comma key to insert. And now if we press the up arrow to go back to the beginning of that previous clip we trimmed, you'll see that it has not been affected at all. And so we could take different excerpts from the same clip and we can reset in and out points on a clip, and we can also clear in and out points on a clip. So we have all the control, people.
Oh, that was creepy.
All right, now we're gonna go back to this panel with our footage in it. We're gonna press the L key to let go of that last clip and deselect all. And now I want you to notice in the bottom right of this last clip that we just inserted on the timeline, we've got these blue little icons for a video footage icon and an audio waveform icon. And anytime you see something that's highlighted in blue in Premiere, that means it's been selected. And so this is telling us that we have used this footage in our timeline before or somewhere in this project in a sequence already. And if we go up to this clip above this, you'll see that it's white, it's not highlighted in blue. We haven't used this footage. And so those little usage indicators can be helpful for you.
Yes.
By the way, we can also go up to the top of this panel here and click on this down caret icon to see where exactly in this project we've used this footage. And then you can select an instance in this drop-down menu and it's gonna take you right to the time code where the clip was used, which is really useful. Like if you tweaked a clip over here in your sequence just right and you wanna copy and paste it over here in another place in your sequence. Another thing I do all the time when I'm looking for a clip is I'll press Command F when I've got the timeline panel selected, and that'll let me search for a clip in just about any way that I want to. And once I'm done, then Premiere will jump right to that clip in my timeline. Or you can also quickly select a whole bunch of clips at once, which can also save you so much time. All right, that's it for this video, and I'll see you in the next one.